Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. In today's video, guys, we'll be working here on a Dodge Journey, or also known as Fiat Fremont, and we're going to show you guys how to build the cooling system on that thing. Now, we have more than 200 videos on this car, guys. You heard it right, more than 200 videos. Our mission is, guys, to save you as much money as we can by teaching you how to fix your car for free. So, we'll show you guys how to build the cooling system. We have the 3.6 engine here. If you have a 4-cylinder, the procedure might be the same, but this video might be helpful for the 4-cylinder as well. Always double-check everything, double-check your manual. Now, this is your coolant overflow bottle right here, guys. This is your thermostat there. We have a video about thermostat replacement, how to drain the coolant and all that stuff. So, more than 200 videos again, guys. Now, what we'll need to do first, okay, we'll need to open, that's a bleeder valve right here, and we'll start adding coolant once we open the bleeder valve. Okay, so we're going to get that thermostat screw loose. Perfect, just like that. So we'll start adding coolant now, guys. Okay, we'll slowly start adding coolant. That's already pre-mixed coolant. You can see where we get ours from in the description of the video below. While we're adding coolant, we're going to keep eye on the screw that we removed and make sure that we don't have coolant coming out. We'll start seeing coolant coming out, so you have to put a container to catch the coolant that's going to leak out, so you don't make a mess underneath the engine. And when you stop seeing air bubbles for about a minute, probably of slowly adding coolant, I will put the screw in. That's how we usually do it. So we'll grab a little bit more coolant and we'll continue. Okay, let us show you now. It just started leaking out. Okay, and we don't see any air, so we're gonna catch some of the coolant out. But we don't see any air coming out, so that's a good thing. We're going to go ahead, place the screw now. The bleeder screw. Okay, and it's still leaking a little bit even when you catch it, so that's fine. Even if you have some air, it's going to come out. And we're going to get this one tight now. Yeah, okay, perfect. Always, guys, inspect your radiator cap because it might have cracks, okay, on the seal and stuff like that. If it does, you have to replace it, like this one. We're going to order a new one because you can see right here it started developing small cracks. So, as a result, guys, your car might overheat from a bad radiator cap. So we'll just need to add a little bit more coolant there, you can see, to get to the maximum line that says cold field. Okay, that's it, right there. Next, we need to install our radiator cap on, get it tight all the way. Okay, like that. Next, you need to, for the next procedure, you need to get your car out of the shop. Do not ever start the car inside the shop and let it run because you can die. So I have just a cheap scanner here, guys, that's very affordable but does really good stuff. We're going to connect it to the OBD so we can watch the coolant temperature live and see, make sure that the car doesn't overheat. Next, we're going to go ahead and start the car. Okay, I'll start it like that. And we're going to make sure, okay, let me turn now the climate on. We need to wait a little bit of time. Okay, let me turn the light so you can see. Okay, we accept climate. So we need to turn, okay, the temperature up. Okay, temperature up on left and right side. Okay, all the way up. If you have the climate control, and the fan needs to be all the way on high like that. Next, we're going to go under diagnose. It's going to connect now, and okay, let me see if it's better without the light. Yep. We need to go ahead, click OK. We're going to go to data streaming here. And under data streaming, we'll see view all items supported. Okay. And this one right here, it says coolant temperature right now, 84, 86. You can see it's climbing 87. At 230, I believe the fan will turn on. That's what our ECU is set at. So we need to make sure that it doesn't overheat past that point. Now, do that only in the open, do not do it in your garage. So we will let the car idle now for about 5 to 10 minutes. We'll keep eye on the gauge here as well. It needs to be about right in the middle, okay? And we actually have on ours the screen where we can check the temperature, so we don't even need to use the computer if you have the screen. And we'll make sure that it doesn't overheat, and we'll show you what next needs to be done. If you have, guys, the rear controls, turn them all the way on high and the fan on high as well. Okay, all the way on high, because that way it will circulate the coolant through the rear heater core, which is located, okay, behind that quarter panel right there. So you can see now we reached about almost 200 degrees, up here 200, it's right in the middle. We definitely have hot air coming from the heater, but when you reach 200, guys, now we have to keep eye on the temperature gauge. What we're going to do, we're going to rev the car between 2 and 3000 RPMs for 2 minutes. So I'll not video the whole thing, but we're going to rev it like that, okay, for 2 minutes. And that way we'll get some air pockets out of it. Okay, you can see the temperature dropping. So it means that, okay, we had an air pocket somewhere, because you can see we just dropped the temperature quite a bit. So we'll do that for about 2-3 minutes and we'll come back. So ours is not overheating, guys, at all. We revved it at 2:30, we'll have the fan turn on, but the car doesn't overheat. The heater feels really warm on the left, right side and the back as well. So you need to make sure that the third row, if you have a third row seating, that you have heat in the back as well. Most likely you don't have air pockets, but stay with us and I'll explain what else needs to be done. So for the next step, we need to turn the car off. So now we're out of the car. The coolant will be extremely hot, guys. Never ever do anything stupid to open that, because that will severely burn you. You can see the it's a little bit low now. We will let the engine stay overnight. It's going to get more coolant if we have any air pockets. And later, all we have to do is just add coolant. And if you suspect any air pockets, do the same thing what we did already. And just test drive it short distance, keep eye on the temperature gauge. And that should be all, guys. So thank you for watching and see you guys next time.